Hello everyone, welcome to PhysicaTube. In this video I will discuss how to find torque or dipole moment of an electric dipole which is placed in uniform electric field. Uniform electric field means the electric field is same at every place. So let us consider that this is a uniform electric field. It is acting in this direction along the positive x-axis, and a dipole is placed in this electric field. So this dipole consists of minus q and plus q charge, and dipole length is equal to 2L. So now how to find torque? Let us first find the force acting on the dipole. So force on charge plus q is q into E, if this is the electric field E, and on minus q charge the force is minus qE. So it means the net force acting on the dipole is zero, but the torque which is acting on the dipole is not equal to zero. Why? Because if the force is acting along the same line of action, let us say ki one force is acting in this direction and other force is acting in this direction, and the line of action is same, in that case torque is zero. But if the line of action is different, means one force is acting along this line, other force is acting along this line, and there is a perpendicular distance between the two forces, in that case the torque is not equal to zero. So here also we are having one line of action of the force is this, and other line of action of force is this. So it means there is a torque acting on the dipole and the direction is clockwise. On the negative q charge the direction is like this, and on the positive q charge the direction is like this. So torque is acting on the clockwise direction. So let us consider that this is the center of the dipole, we can say center of mass. So this length is L and the upper half length is L. Let us draw a perpendicular from this point, and this is the perpendicular distance because we know that torque is equal to force into perpendicular distance. So we will find torque for both the forces. So for force QE, F is equal to QE, and the perpendicular distance is equal to this length. What is the value of this length? If this angle is theta, means the dipole is making angle theta with the electric field, then this length is L sine theta, because we know the two components of this L. This horizontal component is L cos theta and the vertical component is L sine theta. So it means this length is L sine theta. So this perpendicular distance is L sine theta. This is for one force, and the other force is again QE. We will consider only magnitude of the forces. So other force is QE into the other perpendicular distance, which is this. So again this length is L sine theta, because if this is the angle theta, then this component is L cos theta and this is L sine theta. So it means for the second force also the perpendicular distance is L sine theta, and we will add these two forces or two torque components, and the net torque acting on the dipole is, we can write this 2QL as P. If P is the dipole moment, it is the product of the charge and the dipole length. So we can write torque is equal to PE sine theta. Now we know that PE sine theta, if torque is a vector quantity, then on the right hand side we can write this term as cross product of two vectors P and E. So this is PE sine theta. We know that if we have AB sine theta, where A and B are two vectors, so this is the cross product of two vectors A and B. We can write it as A cross B or B cross A, both possibilities are there. Similarly, in this case we can write torque as P cross E also, or E cross P. So there is a confusion what should be the actual value of torque. Either it is P cross E or E cross P. So for that let me give an explanation. This is the direction of electric field, and this is a dipole, and dipole is making angle theta with the electric field. So we can say this is the dipole moment direction from minus Q to plus Q, and this is angle theta. So if we consider P cross E, it means this is clockwise direction, and also we know that our torque is in the clockwise direction. It is acting like this on the dipole. So P cross E is clockwise and E cross P is anticlockwise. So from this we can say that torque which is acting on the dipole, its value is P cross E. So I hope you have understood the concept of torque. Thank you.